Hello everybody, it's Claire here from My Creative Spirit with one of my ambassador projects for Graphic 45 to share with you and to show you how to make as well. It's a little photo box, a lovely little gift if you wanted to capture and give a present from an event with just a few photos in, or you could make your own set of them and use them to sort and organise your photos. So this one's been altered from papers from the Ladies' Diary collection, the Deluxe Collector's Edition. And you may have seen this one on my blog. It's been altered in papers from Mother Goose. And this one has a little album inside. I'll just show you that. Just made out of card, just to fit inside. It's got four little pages, double-sided, and the covers, and then room for photo mats to go in both of those pages. And then in the Ladies' Diary one, I love these papers. In the Ladies' Diary one, I've decorated it so it's a little memory book, and then inside, let's just undo it. This one does up in a different way, and this is what I'm going to show you. So it opens up, and inside there are, I've got those to stick down, they should be sitting there. Let's move that out of the way. Three little photo wallets so that you can put your picture up here and perhaps write a note for the pocket at the bottom. And then on the back, I've used the ephemera cards from Mon Amour just to add a little note to the photo wallet as well. So there are three different styles. Little note on the back there. And then one to match the box in the green. So this is how it all came together. Let's just pop these back in the box. So I've made my box so that it's an inch deep, but you could make the depth, any depth that you like, to fit whatever you want to put inside. So the first thing you need is to cut out your card. So the first thing you want to do is to score your large piece of card. So put it into your scorer or paper trimmer with your score blade and score at 3/4 of an inch in from the long edge, and then 1 3/4 inches in from the long edge. I've scored mine already because I'm working upside down. And then turn it round so that you've got your long edge across the top of your scorer or trimmer, and score again at 2.5 inches and 3.5 inches, and then flip over and do the same. Score again at 2.5 inches and again at 3.5, and that gives you all the score lines you need for the big section of your box. And then take your scissors, and you want to cut it like this. Oops, let's move those out of the way. So cut off the very end square, so you're going up through two score lines, and it's not a square, is it? It's an oblong and a long. And then cut off the bottom square. And then cut up by this middle section through the first score line up to the second. And then just taper that little tab slightly, like that. And then taper the bottom of at the bottom tab there, and then do this again. So cut straight up to the second score line and just mitre the bottom tab. Cut the bottom square off, so cut across to the next score line, then cut right up to the second score line. Shape those little tabs, that little square, so just cut the sides off slightly.
and cut out the whole of this end section. If you find it easier, you could do all of that with your paper trimmer. I've just used the scissors. And that gives you that shape. So let's just get rid of the bits. And then you want to take your bone folder and crease all of the fold lines. So if you do it one way first, open it out, do the little bottom ones. It just sharpens those folds. And then when it's all folded up together, it will give the box some structure. So you'll have nice straight edges. Now with these side flaps, you want to turn your piece over and just score them again, because they're going to flip in and outwards. So they need to go both ways, like that. And then you're all ready to stick it together. So the other pieces that you need are the narrow strip, which has scored 3/4 of an inch in from both ends. And I've put double-sided tape on both ends of that one. And then you want your long lid section, which is scored in at 3/4 and then 1 3/4. And then you want to put tape on your box section like this. So a little piece on the two tabs, and a piece or two pieces just on that end flap of the centre section. So take your backing strips off your little tabs, the tape on the back of the tabs, and also tape on this centre section. Let's just stick that there. And then you want to fold in the side so the tab is upright, and square the corner nearest to you and pinch to stick the little tab inside underneath this top flap, and then do the same on the other side. So get your corners together and stick, and then really crease these side flaps so that they sit outwards. Crease the centre section so it stays in, and then you want this piece. Take your tape off the side sections, or backing tape. I thought it would be easier using the scissors. I'm not sure that it is. And this piece then sits over this one and down and sticks to the inside of the sides. So it's a bit tricky because everything is sticky. So you want to just sort of hover it over, slide those side tabs in, and line up the bottom edge with the bottom edge of your box at the same time without it all sticking. And then when you've got everything level, then you can firm it down to the side level. And by adding this extra little piece, it just makes the box, let's just fold this in slightly, it gives it a bit more structure. I just want to pinch this one slightly so that it's just slightly too big. You may just have to jiggle around yourself to get the piece in. That's it. And then stick it down so that the little box that you've added is flat and your side folds fold in over the top. And then you can tip it on one side and just use your bone folder just to really stick down those side sections. Bit fiddly again, but we can do it. So that's the bottom of the box made. And now we want to add the lid section, which is easy. So take your tape off the little tab. and it's going to sit underneath the centre structure of the box. So just line them up. So I'm lining up the score line. And then when you're happy with where it's sitting and it folds up, stick it firmly in place. And that is the structure of the box. So now we're all ready to decorate it. So start to cut your pieces out and I'll see you back in the next video and we'll get altering. So before we stick any papers down, we want to put a magnetic closure onto the front flap and this bottom pocket. So I'm taking some of our black construction tape, but you could use sticky tape. And I'm going to put two, she says maybe not. I'm going to put two magnets. Let's just unstick that. I can't slide them apart. One, and I'm just sticking them onto the tape about half an inch apart, and then I'm going to stick that tape in the centre on this box section, really firm it down, and then I can fold the box up, bring the lid in, and then take your second set of magnets and just let them attract to the first set that's stuck down like that, and then just cover them with some double-sided tape or black construction tape. And then we know that the box closes really nicely and the magnets are stuck in place. And then just lift the box up, pop it down flat, and make yourself a ribbon loop. Just with a 3-inch piece of ribbon, you hold the ends together to make a loop and then stick it onto some tape. And then stick that in place, so centrally along this edge. I'm using the eyeball technique, but you could measure it. And then just for extra security, add a little bit of double-sided tape over the top. Remembering to come in a quarter of an inch from the edge so that when you stick your papers in place you won't see the sticky tape. So now we're good to go and we can start decorating the box. So I've already got my papers cut and I thought I'd inked all my edges, but I haven't. I'm using a vintage photo distress pen because I only wanted to colour the very edge of the paper. So I'm just running the pen across the edge just to get rid of that white core. It doesn't look very nice when you stick it on a dark colour. Just check the other ones. Yeah, I think the other's done. And then we're ready to start sticking our pieces in place. Now you can use double-sided tape or tacky glue for this. I'm going to use double-sided tape, so I'm going to speed up the video. You don't want to see me sticking and pulling tape backings off. So I'm going to cover the front, the back and the sides. And once I'm done, then we'll move on to the inside. So my box is all decorated. I hope yours is too, if you're following along. So now we can open it up and stick the floral papers into the inside and onto the two flaps here. So let's get started with those. Now I cut these two pieces so the pattern follows on. So let's just get them in the right place. place and stick them down. So I got in a mess with my tape. I'm a glue girl, definitely. So I'm just going to use tacky glue to stick these pieces on. But you can use whatever you fancy, glue or tape. I'm having a problem with the glue bottle as well, would you believe it? That's better. So if you're going to use glue, you don't want to put too much onto the paper, and just let it soak in for a minute before you stick your pieces down. So I've glued that one, I'm going to glue this one and then stick them on. I always like to put glue across the middle as well, or tape if I'm using tape, so that the paper sticks to the whole surface and then you don't get any bubbles. Let's just pop that one down there. Get the glue off my fingers and then we can start. So, top flap. I like the glue too because you've got a little bit of wiggle time to get it in place, to get your paper in place before the glue starts to really stick. So, make sure that your edges are all really nicely stuck down so that they're not bubbling up at all. Lining up the flowers that way, pop it on, jiggle it about, get it in the right place, and then stick it down. The flaps are good because you can put them out flat down on your work surface. I'm just going to move that along. Stick it down. I love these papers. I love the pinks and the greens together. Really Edwardian feel. So smooth it all down and then it will look lovely on the inside of your box. And then we've got the large pieces to put on as well. So now, did I cut these to match? Let's just have a look. Although we've got a divider in between, so they go on the inside like that. So let's stick them down. No, I don't think they match. Such a shame to cover up this paper. I love it. That's always the problem with double-sided papers. You like both sides and you don't want to use them. So what do? Put them back in the cupboard. No, we have to cut into them. The lovely thing with Graphic 45 papers is whatever you make, it will always look gorgeous because you're starting off with something that's really classy. Or classy, classy, classy. You know what I mean. Stick the little middle piece down. Make sure that it's clear of the fold. And maybe I'll move it over just a little bit. Just lift it up. Looks better. So, stick it back down and then the piece inside the base. Oh, look, gotta go, lady. Getting in the right 2 and 8. And then this piece you can just slide on in. So I'm going to get my flowers going the same way. Get the glue off my fingers. So it's starting to look really pretty now. So position it, I can't see. Let's just lift it up. Let me just turn it this way and then I can see where I'm
sticking it. And then firm it down. You might want to use your bone folder just to smooth the paper down. Let's use that end right into the bottom, all the way around on the edge. Beautiful. So now it really is starting to take shape. So the next thing to do is to cut the pieces out for the inside here and get those stuck on, and the two little side pieces. So cut them out and then we'll put them all into our box. So here we go, finishing off the basic decoration. So I'm going to pop the long pieces, these long spotty pieces, in first. So I'm just going to tip the box up on its side. Let's do it like this, and you should be able to see. I'm just sliding this long piece in to the bottom section and sticking it down. I need to turn the box up onto its side though, because I want to press down on the work surface. So do that with your little pieces. And then I'm going to use the bone folder just to push the paper down and stick it underneath the box end. So that's one spotty side in. Let's do the other spotty side. I love anything spots. I'm completely obsessed with them. Spots and stripes are the first papers I go to. And if I'm shopping, certainly if I'm down by the sea, anything that is stripy, sea-themed, I love it. Just going to turn that one around. So, stick it on in. Just smooth it down with the bone folder. Poke it right into the bottom of the box. Sure the sides are nicely stuck down. Right, let me turn it round again. So fiddle around with your side sections and get those stuck in. This one doesn't want to behave. Let's be really firm with it. That's it. And then we've just got these top sections to put on. So I've gone back with the greens. And then for the bottom section, I've just put a strip of this sticker, the nice scalloped sticker, onto the paper. And they're going to go on the box like that. So let's stick those pieces on too. Hide all the ladies. I thought these colours gave a really nice base to put the detail on, a really nice background for the detail. I'm just going to lay that on there a minute, glue this one, and then firm them down. So add your pieces too. One on the middle bit. And then we're ready to do some decorating. That's the exciting bit, isn't it? And then you can lift your side sections up again and really firm them down when you've got them where you want them.
amazing, actually, how much glue you can squeeze out with the bone folder that you can't get with your fingers. So that is it. Our little box is all ready to alter. Let's just check that it all folds up nicely again. So cut out the next set of pieces to decorate the front, and then we'll stick them together. So now we're ready to stick all of the pieces onto the front of our box. So start with your memories cut out, and using glue or tape, stick it in place. So come down in about half an inch, down about half an inch from the top edge. And this paper's good, you can follow the line of the paper to stick it in place. And then mount your timeless word sticker, backed on black card, on some foam pads, and that one sits half on, half off, just at the top edge, like that. And then let's position the other bits before we stick them on. So we've got in, pictures is at the bottom. And then we've got the clock. Let's stick the clock on the scalloped circle. I've backed mine with a little bit of black as well. You don't have to do that. I always think I can draw a circle or cut a circle. I can't. So I don't cut the scallop. So centre the clock up on the die. Down. And then work out which is the top. I've cut this piece so that it sits right up at the side, and I've kept that straight edge of the roses, so that one can actually go straight onto the cover. So I'm just going to put some tape on that, stick it on with some tape, so that it definitely sticks flat. But you could use glue or tape. So let's just pull those backings off. And then once this piece is on, then we can line up everything else. So line it up at the edge, so that it overlaps. I got it straight. I'm so bad at doing straight upside down. Okay. And then we've got the flower spray that sort of comes across here. I lost my carnation, but I thought actually he could be stuck on separately. And then the separate flower that just goes over the top like that. So once you're happy with where everything's sitting, then you can start to stick your pieces in place. So let's do the little inward. I'm just going to pop that on like that. And then stick these flowers down here first. I've inked the edges just with a distress pen, and I always ink from the back so I don't get such a grungy look on the front, but I get rid of those white edges. So where's that going to go? Just on there, slightly over the clock. Stick my little carnation down. Is it a carnation? I don't know, actually. I always think they are. I love them. And then
the rose over the top. So just so that it covers the other one, like that. I like that dimension on it. And then we can add the last of our words. Now, on the original box, I did cover the words with glossy accents, just so they had a nice shiny raised look to them. And if you do that, I'll show you, the individual stickers disappear. And it looks like it just is one word. So there we are, timeless memories in pictures, all ready for us to decorate inside. And here's the one I made earlier. So we've got a set. So cut out your pieces for inside, and then we'll come back and put them all together. So now we're ready to put all of the elements on the inside of our box. So make sure you've got yours up the right way. Open the flap and let's move those to one side. We'll start by putting the tag. I've used my initial, and also I've put a little sticker in here. So it says CC, which is me. And then when we get on the other side, I've chosen June 2016 as my sticker wording. But you can choose whatever you want, obviously, for your project. So on the back of this, I have stuck a piece of the contrasting paper and then put double-sided tape down the left-hand side and the bottom edge. Left-hand side when it's stuck down. I also put some tape at the top just to hold the sticker on, but I'm going to leave that on, and I'm going to position that about there. So 3/4 of an inch in from the left, 1/2 inch up from the bottom, and that forms the pocket for the ephemera card, and that's one of the small ones from the Monomore collection. I just thought it went really nicely. Might stick a little stamp on. I've got some bits cut out here. Yeah, let's stick that on. And then it ties it in. Ties it in with this collection. So now, once those are in place, we've got... I'm picking up the wrong pile of bits. Here they are. Those are for the next side. So let's just take that out, actually. Now, I've just used bits of clocks from the edge of the paper, and they just sort of overlap each other. So I've inked the edges, and I'm just going to stick them on. So if you've been cutting up your papers and you've got lots of off cuts left, have a look through, see what you can use, but don't worry that you haven't got a whole clock. It's going to go that way. I'm just checking to see which way up it goes, but it has to go that way. And then this one just overlaps at the top so that you've got both clocks. So stick your little elements down. Spread out the glue, especially on those little edge pieces. Make sure that your glue goes right to the edge of everything. And then line it up with the top and the right-hand edge and stick it down. Just move it slightly. So that's in place. And then I cut some flowers out for this corner as well. So I've got the rose. I'm just wondering whether I don't want to cover up my name. So you decide which flowers you're going to add. Perhaps I'm just going to add those just at the bottom. So work out what you're going to stick on and stick them down. So it just ties the whole pocket in with the page. So it doesn't just look like it's been stuck on all by itself. And then you can slide your little tag underneath. And that could be your gift tag. Something else that would be really good to use are the new to and from tags from Graphic 45. Have you seen those? Fabulous little staples. So that's the inside cover decorated. And now we're going to move on to this side. So gather up your pieces. So the first thing we want to do is to add our ribbon, and the ribbon goes on the back of the box. So turn your box over, take your ribbon, find the centre. So it's about 18 inches long, the ribbon. And I've put a strip of tape about an inch in from the edge here, and I'm just going to centre and stick the ribbon onto the tape. Let's just pull it straight so that it's only stuck on the back, and then it can be folded up and tied in a bow on the front. You always get frayed ends on ribbons, no matter how well you cut them. So I quite like to add little circles to the end. It gives some weight to the end of the ribbon. And if you add glossy accents on top of the circles, once you've got them stuck together, and you can put your box to one side to dry, it gives the ends of the ribbons a little bit of weight as well. So, quick tip on adding these little circles. So these are 5/8 with 1/2-inch circles cut out of the paper, is put glue on one piece, put the second one on the top and smooch them around so that they're both covered in glue, and then take the end of your ribbon, stick it to one, and then sandwich the other one over the top. And because they're both covered in glue, they stick together beautifully. So that's one. The trouble is, you do two. And then the other one. So glue all over. Give them a smooch. And then take your ribbon end, sandwich them together, and then you haven't got any frayed ends showing. And then just sort of wiggle them around until you're happy that they're sitting over the top of each other, and give them a good press and leave them to dry, and then we can get on with the box. So details for the inside. You could cut out any pieces that you've got left. I've got a clock. Which way does that go? 2, 3. Maybe it goes... Does it go that way? I can't work these clocks out. Yeah, it goes that way. So mine's just a bit too long. So I'm going to take my scissors, and I'm just going to move it slightly lower than I want it, and then use the edge of the box as my guide, just to cut the bottom off. And then if I move it up, it fits perfectly on that bottom section. So let's inky the edge. Do it from the wrong side. Just go all the way around with the pen. And stick it on down. So work out what you're going to use and
stick. Now, I know I've got a sort of straight edge here of flour, so I thought, oops, what else have we got? I've got some cut from the other papers. So maybe just a blossom on the top will work. So let's stick that one down. Just to cover that straight edge. Like that. And then for the top, I'm going to put that lovely spray of roses at the top, like that. So let's inky around the edge. I've forgotten that. See, if you're working from the wrong side, it doesn't matter if your pen slips. I think, oh, I won't ink the edges, I'll just stick it down. But I can't. I'm an obsessive edge inker. Little bit of glue on the rosebud, smooch it all about, and stick it on down. Beautiful roses. Let's just get rid of the glue on my finger. And then press it on down. Like that. Wink of Stella looks lovely on these elements. Oh, I was going to add 4711. My grandma always used to wear 4711. I was really excited to see it in the paper collection. I can see the bottle and I can smell it now. Is it made in Belgium? I can't remember. So there we are. Now, all we've got to do is add our words. So I'm going to place them. I did stick them half on and half off the top flap. Oops. So let's get them all on. So as I said, I've gone June, 2016. So J-U-N-E. Hopefully that'll fit. 2016. We'll come right up here. And then 2001. It's going to go over my 4711. So I'm going to go down there. Come across the top here. That's it. So decide where you want to put your words if you're putting them on your project. So what I've used is a 5/8 of an inch punch for the black circles, and then the stickers fit on perfectly. And you get the nice black border as well. So I'm just sort of roughly putting them into place on the glue. I was just looking at the U and the N, trying to work out which is which from an upside down perspective. Ah, now don't forget the ribbon. I've just thought of that, so let's move these along a little bit and get rid of the glue. The ribbon comes along and ties, so let's pop that over there, and then I can see, let's go along just a little bit further. So remember that when you're sticking your words on or letters on. So let's go in June and then twizzle them so that they are sitting nice and straight. You can go half on, half off if you want to, like I did on the other project. Be fine. Just de-stick there. And then 2016 are good to go down here. So 2 0. I punched out the 1, stuck it on its black circle. Do you think I can find it? It's vamooshed. So I'm using the 7, but I'm sticking it so that it's straight, in the hope that no one will notice. So did you notice? Okay. Now, I know they're on, but I need to turn it round just to check that they're all straight. So bear with. It's okay. And I'm not quite 2016. Okay, and when you're happy with them, just give them a real squidge so that they stay in place. So that way we've got June 2006. It's by me, with my initials, and then we can tie up. So the bow really is just for decoration. I just thought it looked really nice with the papers. And then the whole thing shuts up. So that is it. That's how to make the box. And then I'll give you the sizes for the photo. Let's get them the photo books for the inside. And show you how to make one of those too, if you want to put one together. So, snippy out your pieces, and we'll be back in a minute. And here's how to put the photo wallet together. Just put your black card section to one side and just gather up these 3 pieces. Just to move those out of the way. And we're just going to piece these together. And this is what I did around the bottom of the box that goes with this photo wallet goes in. So take yourself some double-sided tape and turn, I don't know why I turned them all over actually, just turn one of your pieces over, put double-sided tape half on, half off down one edge, and then without inking the edges, I've taken the border strip and you just push it right up against the paper edge so that it sits on the tape but flat, and then put tape on this side, turn over, and then take your other piece of paper and butt it right up against the edge of the border, press it down nice and flat, and then you've got a really nice joined section of paper that is completely flat. And then I'm just going to trim off that end with my scissors, trim off that edge, and then cut it to size. So those pieces were slightly too large and it needs to be, I think it was 6-3, yeah, 6-3 is that right? Just check before you cut. Check twice, cut once. 6-3. So I just want to tidy up that bottom edge. If I can. Like that. Okay, now we're ready to stick everything together. So, pieces that we need are the piece that we've just joined. We've got a little tag to go on there. We've got a little phrase. And we've got our little buttons and our black ribbon. So, first thing to do is take a piece of tape, two pieces of tape, and just put them about a half an inch in from the edge of this little flap. This one's too big, let's rip it in half. Like that. Take the backings off both. She says, can't do that. Oh, it doesn't want to come off. Okay. And then take one end of your ribbon, stick it onto the tape, and then take it around the back of your wallet and back over and stick it onto the tape on the other side. And that way you've created a pocket on the back. We're going to stick these little buttons on so that you can put your gift card in. And then on the front, or inside, you've got the whole width to be able to put a photo in. So now we can stick our papers on. Let's grab that one. To the inside and the front. So I'm just going to stick that one on there so that that tape doesn't catch. And then we'll come back to the inside in a minute. But at least the tape's hidden. So, front cover. I've used the tonic punch just to shape the corners on my piece. So that is too long. Yours will be the right size because I'll have given you the right measurements, but 6-1. I'm cutting everything wrong. So now it's the right size. I'm just going to punch the corners. I love this stub punch, and then I'm going to ink the edges. So do that if you haven't done it already. Let's go around. Oops. That one, and then take the backing tapes off your tape on the back. A little bit of glue, and we're good to go. It's a bit bendy, but it will fit on perfectly. She says, let's do a bit of jiggling at the top. Just where I cut that extra section off. And for some reason that corner's not quite lined up, so I'm just going to trim it slightly so that it carries on curving round. Just ignore me while I'm talking to myself. So now that's on, we can put our tag on. I'm not going to add any foam pads to this because you want your wallets to all fit into your little box. Depending on how many you add, of course, you might want to just do two or three and there will be room for foam pads. But I'm just going to stick my piece on flat like that on there, and then afternoon tea is going to just go across like that. So that one I'm just going to use a little bit of glue for, and stick it on like that. And then on the back, I haven't put any paper on the back, I've just left it completely plain, but I want to be able to put the little tag in the back. So let's just get a tag. And I don't want it to fall out. So my thought was, maybe the buttons need to be bigger. Stick a button on there and a button on there, and then the little tag will fit in nicely and stay stuck in. So let me just get the 3/4 inch punch and cut some bigger circles to go over the ribbon. And they will work. So onto those, I've just got some little script circles, little half inch circles. Just punched from off cuts of the paper. So stick those together, center them up. I'm not very good at doing that. And then a little bit of glue. I'm going to smooch them again. So a little bit of glue on the back of one and just roll them around on top of each other, and then they're both completely covered in glue, and stick them down over your ribbon. Just so that your tag just sits in that space between them. You can always put a little bit of glue under the ribbon as well if you find your little pieces won't stick down. In fact, let's do that. Just a little squirt. If you wanted to clamp that as well, you can. So that's quite a nice little back for our wallet. And now we're ready to decorate the inside. So let's start sticking. Now, because we've used the ribbon, we've got the full width of the pocket to be able to slide the paper in. So let's inky up the edge. Actually, I didn't do the other piece, so I'll just do it now. Ooh, maybe we'll go this side. Let's have a look and see what she looks like. So we could do that, or keep it plain. I think I'm going to keep mine plain so that if I put a photograph on the top here, you can see it. So sorry lady, you're going to go on the wrong side, much as I love her. Stick that down. And then the bottom piece can just slide straight into the pocket. Squiggle, squiggle. Oh, gosh. Got the whoopsies.
Oh no.
So slide it in just so that it sits under the fold at the top and stick it down. And then I thought that would work just so that it matches the front. So it was just an offcut of the border left over. Smooch the glue out Just line it up with the top. So line it up with the top and stick it down. And then the other bits. And then just position and stick your other pieces on the top section. So pluck at the edge. Flowers around it. Stick those down. Now I've got a few more little roses or little flowers cut out. I don't know, you can go flower mad, can't you? Just over there, I think. I don't know. Yep, we'll stick them on. Do the thinking before you start doing the video, and then we know where we're going. Let's just move that leaf. Actually, I'm just going to trim that leaf, otherwise it will get creased. And that is it. That is the little photo folder, all ready to go in our little photo box. So let's get the box. Here it is. It's losing its card. Open it on up. Oh, got a picture of the bambinos. So the wallet is just the right size to put a 6x4 photo on the top, and also to slide one in the pocket as well. Or if you just want to put photos in the box, they fit really nicely as well. So that is it. That is the little... It keeps falling out. It's not doing very well, is it? Stay in there. That is the little photo box and photo wallets, altered in the ladies' diary papers. From Graphic 45. Don't forget to give me the thumbs up if you like the video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and be kept up to date with projects as they come out.